Hello, welcome to morning prayer for Wednesday the 2nd of June 2021. For this service you'll need a Bible of your own so that you can read it yourself, and you'll also need some facility for putting me on hold while we do that, because the essence of the service is that we each take the time to read the scriptures at our own leisure and ask God to speak to our hearts through what he says. Let's ask him into our hearts and onto our lips at the beginning of our service today. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Stephen Craven chooses an opening hymn for our service, and the one for today is by Timothy Dudley Smith, Christ Pours His Grace Into Our Lives, and the tune is by Anne Harrison.
Christ pours his grace upon his own, and where the word of life is sown, there shall the fruits of grace be grown. To him be glory, whose cross and passion have bought and saved us. To God be glory. God's changeless love shall never fail. Though powers of sin and death assail, his purpose stands and shall prevail. To him be glory, our great Creator, eternal Father. To God be glory. Come, Spirit, then, and make us one. Fulfill your work of grace begun. And now, as Father, Spirit, Son, to God be glory. From us, his children, throughout all ages, to God be glory. To God be glory, from us his children throughout all ages, to God be glory.
The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. Please pause this video as you pray yourself. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen.
The psalm set for morning prayer in the Church of England's liturgy today is Psalm 119, the first four stanzas, that's to say verses 1 to 32. So here's a sung version of part of those verses.
Lord, may your scripture speak to me and guide me in my ways, and through their precepts may I see how I should spend my days. Then I would not be put to shame, but live by your commands, and find protection in your name and blessing from your hands. How can I keep my spirit pure by living by your word? How can I wrestle doubt, be sure, by following what I've heard? So teach me, Lord, may I recount the statutes you have given. Discover you to be the fount of life and peace and heaven. Lord, touch my eyes that I may see the wonders in your laws. So may my mood my heart's desire.
And you might like to pause and reflect on those verses of the Psalter, reading them yourself in your own Bible. Today's Old Testament reading is Job chapter 9. It's Job's continuing reply to what Bildad said in chapter 7. I suppose the thing about Job is that actually there's quite a lot of beautiful literature, for all that the poem is of a very sad nature overall. Please pause the video and read that part of Job in your own Bible. Well, in particular, the part of the reading which deals with some of the beauties of creation and the intricacy and wonders of it have been taken up in many hymns, and here's one of them, O Worship the King, All Glorious Above.
O worship the King, all glorious above, O gratefully sing his power and his love. Our shield and defender, the ancient of days, pavilioned in splendor and girded with praise. O tell of his might, O sing of his grace, whose robe is the light, whose canopy space. His chariots of wrath the deep thunder clouds form, and dark is his path on the wings of the storm. The earth with its store of wonders untold, Almighty, thy power hath founded of old, hath established it fast by a changeless decree, and round it hath cast like a mantle the sea. Frail children of dust and feeble as frail, in thee do we trust, nor find thee to fail. Thy mercies, how tender, how firm to the end, our maker, defender, redeemer and friend.
The New Testament reading today is St. Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 5, verses 1 to 11. Please pause the video and read that in your own Bible. What a wonderful passage of scripture, that God, although we were sinners, gave himself up for us in order that he would bring us back into his presence. And all these things like peace and joy and forgiveness are all ours. Here's a hymn which starts in Romans chapter 3 and carries on into these verses in order to try and establish them in our hearts.
Righteousness from our God and Lord in Christ is now made known. All have sinned and fall short of glory, yet are saved by Christ alone. God made him our sacrifice, from his death we gain new life. Therefore, since we are justified and rescued by our faith, we have peace with our God and Father, brought by Jesus' saving grace. God gave Jesus for our peace, from his death we gain release. We rejoice in our sufferings, we know they lead to growth, inner strength and resilience for disappoint us now, for God poured out his love in our hearts by his Spirit moving. We're assured of life above. God through Jesus called us home. By his death we are his own.
We have received our reconciliation through Jesus. Therefore, the way is open for us to come into the presence of our God and to lay before him the things on our hearts. Let's do that. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are a God of wonders and beauties in creation. And although there is much suffering in the world and evil that we do not understand and causes for despair, there is nevertheless also much duty, much beauty, much joy and much fulfillment. We thank you for the beauties of creation, and especially as we're enjoying the spate of good weather at the moment, we give you our thanks for the beauties of nature that each of us can see. And we pray that you would help us to appreciate these, even though we might be going through dark times of struggling in ourselves. Help us to be able to put before you the difficulties which we feel in our own faith, as Job did, that we might come through to prosperity at the end, as he did, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Father, we ask that your scriptures would continue to speak to us all our days, and therefore help us to make time and effort into putting to understand your word and its impact on our lives. Help us to be diligent in reading you and in understanding what you have to say to us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we give you our thanks, Heavenly Father, for the peace and the joy and the fulfilment which Paul speaks of in Romans chapter 5, and ask that we might experience it ourselves and be able to pass it on to others, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please pause the video and put before God the things that are particularly on your own heart at the moment. One of the collects for the week following Trinity Sunday. Almighty and eternal God, you have revealed yourself as Father, Son and Holy Spirit, and live and reign in the perfect unity of love. Hold us firm in this faith, that we may know you in all your ways, and evermore rejoice in your eternal glory, who are three persons in one God, now and forever. Amen. And let's use the Lord's Prayer as Jesus himself taught his first disciples.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
And so let us continually rejoice in our Lord God, through Jesus Christ, through whom we have received reconciliation.